Thank you. Can you just give me your reaction to today's historic events?
Well, this is a historic event because it's the first time since we started the convention in 1992 that we are able to approve a universal, legally binding climate change agreement. It's a historic breakthrough. And I'm very proud also that Europe is a history of success because we started an alliance with other countries, African, Caribbean, Pacific countries, in order to have a high ambition coalition. We started, but people started joining. The United States came, Japan, Australia, Brazil, and it started being big. And we have been able to incorporate to the agreement all the elements of ambition needed to be an agreement fit for purpose. We have a long-term goal, 2 degrees toward 1.5 degrees centigrade. We have a dynamic process of raising the level of ambition every 5 years with a stock-taking procedure, and we have clear transparency and accounting rules, and mainly a very big financial package to support the development of the countries which need, the least developed countries, to support them in adaptation to climate change and in mitigation efforts. So it's a very ambitious agreement, it's a robust agreement, it's a universal agreement, much more different from Kyoto. In Kyoto, only 38 countries who cover 12% of emissions global were there. Now, it's all the countries of the United Nations together. We cover hundreds of emissions. We have a direction of travel, the long-term goal. We have a way of raising ambition over time, and we must be able to stop global warming. So I'm very happy that we were able to reach this agreement. It has taken lots of effort. We have a big failure in Copenhagen. We learned from the mistakes we made then, and we have been able to deliver what the next generations need. I am extremely proud.
What does the EU have to do now? What does this signal send to the EU?
We are going to implement our
burden-sharing debates and things happening next year.
We have to do two things. First, to reach our targets. We have the most ambitious targets of all the countries in this COP, 40% reduction of emissions in 2030, and 80 to 95% in 2050. We have to fulfill our targets, and also we have to support our friends, our developing countries, with financial support, and we will increase our level of support.
And what do you say to the UK, which has been criticised for reducing its kind of renewables policies recently? What is your message to the UK?
We have a joint objective of 40% reduction of emissions in the European Union together, and we will do it with the United Kingdom. They have also they are developing nuclear, but they have to achieve their targets as all the rest of the European Union. But this is a collective effort, and we would support our British friends achieving their targets. The Commission is here to support, not to criticize or to naming and blaming somebody. This is a collective effort, and this COP gives a very clear message. All the countries must make the transition towards clean energies, renewable energy, energy efficiency, and good management of agriculture, forest policy, transport, and buildings.
Perfect. Thank you very much.